The days of the great ocean liners are ended, but the tradition of elegance that we associate with names like Cunard lives on. It lives on, for example, in Manxman, known as a little Cunarder, but perhaps that's just a little bit patronising to speak of her as a little Cunarder, for she's owned by the Isle of Man Steam Packet Company, and they've been in existence even longer than Cunard. But it's not just a tradition of elegance that lives on. A fine marine engineering tradition lives on as well, for she too is powered by steam turbine engines. The first thing you notice when you come down here is that there's a lot more space in this engine room than there was in Tobinya, and the engines themselves are a good deal larger as well. There are two turbines driving two shafts. Now, the great thing about the steam engine is that it's simple and it's robust. Here are the two sets of controls. The message comes down the telegraph. All the engineer has to do is open up and allow the steam to come through the engine. And this little indicator here shows him how much steam is pushing through. And of course, he has to tell the chaps in the boiler room what's happening. And that's rung through here. And just as the engines are bigger, so too, the boilers themselves are a great deal larger than they were on old Tobinya. The steam turbine represents the ultimate development in marine steam engines. And it might seem, too, that it represents the very end of a line of development. But who's to say, in an oil-starved world, if a steamer might not yet again come into its own?